Welcome back to Wolf and Ties Podcast. Today we're talking about 2003's Kill Bill Volume 1.
Are they doing a Volume 3? I've heard a lot of talk about it.
I remember he talked about it. I don't know if he's going to... I wouldn't want to do that as his last film.
Yeah, because Volume 3 really wouldn't make that much sense because they literally kill Bill.
And he's on a franchise sequel kind of guy because Kill Bill 1 and 2 was split. He already had it all as one movie. He kind of milked the money for Weinstein.
Yeah, I guess. Well, David Carradine's dead too as well. So he'd have to recast Bill. I've heard rumblings about it, but there's been so many rumors over the past fucking 10 years with Quentin Tarantino.
Yeah, I hope he doesn't.
He's going to do a Star Trek movie. He's going to do a horror movie. I'm like, I don't know what he's going to do. He can't really guess what kind of movie he's going to make next.
I know. I really want to do a horror movie. He's a big horror genre fan.
Yeah, you could see him doing it.
Yeah, he'd have passion for it.
Like I say, Pulp Fiction's got a little bit of horror in there. He's definitely dabbled in horror.
Yeah, so does this movie. The fucking buck scene. That's horrific.
Yeah, yeah. It is gory. But this one here is fucking a lot of different inspirations in this one.
Yeah, it's almost like she's fighting through genres, movie genres. Yeah. Like each character is represents a subgenre, which I didn't notice till I watched
the whole anime thing with what's her name with Lucy Liu. Ooh, yeah, man. Bob, by the way, she's fucking awesome in this movie.
Yeah, that anime sequence fucking great. I forgot how cool that was.
Yeah, the anime is pretty good actually. I'm a sucker for good anime.
Yeah.
Because anime, it makes you think differently. But I got a buddy that literally only watches anime. That's it. Crazy. He won't watch anything else. Thunders, he won't watch anything else. It's crazy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's it. He won't watch, he is so done with anything American, North American. Yo, have you seen this? No. I've seen this, though, and he names... 150 different anime, and I'm like, I don't fucking know that. I still haven't even seen the old Attack on Titan. The Miramax intro again.
I know, it kind of sucks.
The opening of this is pretty crazy.
Fuck, what happens at the beginning again?
It's right when she shoots. They're at the wedding.
Oh, they're at the wedding, yeah.
They're all standing over her, and Bill's there, and he shoots her right in the head.
Yeah. Bill, it's your
She's got fucking balls though. Says she's got a lot of heart. I shot her in the head and she still goes. She does have a lot of heart in this movie though.
Has that, I think her name's Nancy Sinatra.
Shot me down, bang bang. Yeah, Sinatra did. She did also did these boots made for walking.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a cool opening to this movie.
It also starts out with the revenge is a dish better eaten cold, best served cold.
Yeah.
It starts out with, because this is a revenge movie.
Yeah, 100%.
Yep. And it's it opens with Beatrix Kiddo. You can even tell that her name is Beatrix when they introduce her to the girl's daughter. You can kind of see that she says Beatrix.
Yeah. It's hard to breathe the mouth though until you actually know later.
So you know what it is. You don't know what it is.
Even if you can read lips,
it's a bride forever.
Yeah. Even if you read lips, it's like Beatrix. Like, I don't think anyone would guess that.
Yeah, fucking. I wrote down too. David Carradine is pretty awesome in this movie.
Yeah, man.
He's awesome. Really good in Kill Bill Volume 2, which I'm still kind of, because I didn't have the greatest experience with Volume 2, but I'm kind of looking forward to watching it again.
Me too, actually.
I wanted how the hell did the kid survive that? It was a cesarean section or something like that, and they pulled the baby out of her.
Yeah, something happened.
The kids got heart like the mom's got.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, Lucy Liu, who else? Sonny Chiba. Sonny Chiba's great.
Yeah, the sensei.
Yeah, he's a Hitori Hanzo, isn't he? Isn't he actually Hitori Hanzo, or is it just an Hitori Hanzo sword?
Not sure. I should have looked into that, actually.
Yeah, I don't know either. That's interesting. I think you might just be able to craft the steel together.
Isn't Sonny Chiba the sensei with the beer?
No, Sonny Chiba's the guy that creates the sword maker. Yeah, the sword maker. Yeah. No, that other guy is, I don't even know his name. I think he's another famous guy.
He is a popular, like, kung fu guy from like the 80s or something like that.
He's like cool, like, yeah, with the goatee. Yeah. And fucking the RZA. The RZA. Original music.
Wu-Tang Forever.
Yeah, yeah, which I totally forgot. Like, that's why it's good to watch these again. He's like, I do forget the little things. He's like, oh yeah, RZA did all the music. I totally forgot about that. Yeah,
the music's fucking awesome too.
Yeah, the music is awesome. I'm just saying, like, how I'm not going to have to look hard to find music to put underneath this podcast. Yeah.
Like the slow-mo walk with the Lucy Liu, the...
Yeah, that whole scene's really good. There's a lot of good one takes and like tracking shots through that entire like intro of when they walk into the restaurant there.
Yeah.
Which is just so good. Because, like, she knows she's there. Lucy Liu, or Ren.
Yeah.
You must have saw her when she walked in, because she throws a knife at Beatrix Kiddo.
Yeah. It was like, so how do you know have to, like,
she was there and she was coming and then she was just waiting to kind of hear something? That's when she throws a knife.
Like a sixth sense.
I think she saw her when she was walking in. She probably was walking in, and they're very formal, the Japanese.
Yeah. But
she didn't even notice. Like, she didn't make it look like she noticed.
Yeah, but she's sitting in like a closed room with all those people.
But
like,
as we're walking in, because she's sitting
in the car. I guess.
So
I
she
guess,
was walking in, there's a chance that she might have seen her, and she was waiting for her, because she might have even known that Copperhead.
Cottonmouth? Copperhead.
But she's Cottonmouth, isn't she? Oren's Cottonmouth, I think. And Vivica.
The Eye Patch Girls.
Copperhead.
Texas mountains or California mountain snake is
the California. I put California snake. I didn't get the whole thing. I had to look up her name too. God, what is her name again?
Yo, really Copperhead. I think Cottonmouth is Vivica Fox.
Yeah, she's so she's Cottonmouth. And Oren is Copperhead.
Yeah,
I can't remember. Even though I just watched it. Yeah. But we're at that fight scene with Vivica Fox now.
Yeah, this movie starts off with a bang.
It does start off with a bang, man. That's why I like this movie. And it climbed up the ranks in my turns, you know.
It
moved a bit above Pulp Fiction.
I mean, like, every time you rewatch one, you're gonna, like, have that feeling. I find that a lot with these movies.
Yeah.
Every time I rewatch
them. Death Proof, too, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, me too. I love Death Proof. I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah, fucking Harvey Weinstein. Fucking Harvey Weinstein.
what are you looking at?
Fucking, because, like, we were talking before we recorded about how the creepy guy, Buck, who likes to fuck, and all the pussy wagon and all that shit. Fucking how, like, Quentin Tarantino is good at writing creepy guys.
Yeah.
And he's good probably at because of fucking Harvey Weinstein. Was it Pasadena, California, it looks like? That's where the first fight scene takes place?
Yeah, which is a pretty cool fight scene. Then the school bus pops up. They both have the knives at each other. That's a cool scene. Because
there's a lot of those scenes, actually.
Yeah, they're at like a standoff, the way the camera is. And then in the middle of the frame, the school bus pops up. It's fucking... so well done.
And they're trashing that fucking house, too. Yeah. The fight, like, the actual fighting choreography is really good, too, as well.
Yeah.
Because you can obviously tell that she's got some training, too. The both of them probably trained hard for that fight scene.
Yeah, because I believe Zoe Bell's the stunt double.
Oh, what, for Uma Thurman?
For Uma Thurman, yeah. Like, you know Zoe Bell, she's the...
Sounds really familiar.
She's a New Zealand chick in Death Proof. She's the one who's on the car. She's a stunt double in real life. She's Kurt Russell's wife.
I haven't seen Death Proof in at least a decade. I would probably say more. I don't know. When did it come out?
Late 2000s.
So it was, I must have seen that in like 2009 or something. It's been a while. Like fully through. Because I've seen clips of that one many, 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 many times.
Yeah.
Just clips of the part with them the chicks holding onto the roof.
Yeah,
the,
which is great. The car.
And Kurt Russell.
Yeah, the car scenes in that are really fucking cool. And she's actually on that car going that speed.
I wrote it down, it is Copperhead. She's Copperhead. And the other
one
is Cottonmouth. Oh, okay. Because I wasn't sure. I wrote it down. Yeah, and fucking Uma Thurman does the square thing again. She does it like, we're square. I'm like, oh, that's kind of funny. I wonder if she did it in volume two, too.
I don't know. Yeah.
That's something I'm going to be looking for now, because of course she does that. And it's a pretty iconic scene in Pulp Fiction. Don't be a square.
Yeah.
Like she says, we'll be square to, we'll never be square, is what she said, basically.
Yeah. She's like, square is to wait for your husband to come home, kill him, kill your daughter. Then that'd be, and then she does the square symbol. I was like,
she should be Black Mamba too, Vivek A. Fox. I should have been Black Mamba. Because that's what I thought her name was. And I'm like, it was Black. But that's Beatrix Kiddo, Uma Thurman's Black Mamba. It's just a cool nickname.
Yeah, it is. It's badass.
Because that's fucking, what's his name? Kobe Bryant was the Black Mamba as well.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, so I guess now that was a pretty good scene too, because she's making the fucking cereal for her daughter and she tries to shoot her. And I love a good knife, like a knife throwing death.
Very funny, bitch. Very funny. Kicks a coffee cup at her, throws a fucking knife. Yeah, that was great.
And then the daughter comes in too.
Yeah, which would be fucked. See, that's the Kill Bill 3 storyline.
You think so? That's what they go with?
Yeah. Well, what else would the fuck? Kill Bill's dead.
Unless you do a prequel, but it wouldn't be volume 3 if it was a prequel.
You call it like Kill Mamba and go for the little girl's like perspective. Uma would technically be like the bad slash good.
I think it's a Japanese thing too to say revenge to as you like if somebody kills your parents as a kid, when you grow up, you go and I think that's like in a lot of different cultures actually. You go and kill that person.
Yeah, and they're ready, and they have honor in it too. Like they're expecting that duel eventually.
And that's what she says to her. She's like, "If you're shitty about this, still."
Yeah, exactly.
Woke me up in 20 years.
Yeah, which would be 20 years. 2023 would be 20 years after she said that.
Yeah. Wow. That's actually.
Yeah, because this is 2003. That's actually crazy.
Time's got to slow down. That's fucking nuts. So now we're at the fucking massacre when they're talking about what actually went down in that fucking wedding ceremony. Because they kill everybody. They kill the entire groom's family. They kill the
Samuel Jackson, organ player.
Yeah, was that Sam Jackson, the organ player?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, I had there's a theory that he's Jules from Pulp Fiction, how he went to walk the earth. Because it was a miracle he survived, right?
Yeah.
That was his last. Yeah, so that's where he ended up as an organ player.
Well, I know there's a whole Quentin Tarantino verse, so there's a good chance. Yeah. They like a lot of them kind of linked together in weird ways.
Yeah.
Is it somebody objected? They fucking killed everybody. Killed everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, fucking hard one scene. Rob made a whole fucking note about his. And now we're at the hospital, and I had the fucking whistling thing in my head for.
Yeah. It's my ringtone for a while.
Was it? I couldn't get it out of my head, man. It's I can't get that tone that she can get.
Yeah.
Cause she's like whistling and it's going up and down and like it's pretty cool the actual tune. You kind of get this, but I am not a good whistler like that.
Yeah, it's kind of like a horror score. Like it goes all split screen, and then the music gets intense with the whistle.
Well, she's about to murder her, basically. Yeah. And then Bill calls her.
Yeah.
That's what I couldn't remember what her name was. I'm like, Daryl fucking Hannah. Daryl Hannah. Me, man, because I've seen her in 1,000 things, this chick. Like, it really bothered me that I couldn't remember her name. She has a really good scene in the second one. That's my favorite scene, I think, about Volume 2 is the fight between the two of them.
Yeah, in the trailer.
It's awesome. That whole scene's really good.
The fucking eyeball parts. Ugh. Yeah, steps on the eyeball.
Yeah, and she's freaking out. And I think there's a copperhead. Or it might even be a California mountain snake.
Yeah, it might be.
I think it is a California mountain snake.
Yeah.
Because there's the irony of dying. It's like the guy in Cabin in the Woods.
Yeah, the merman.
The merman, yeah. Fuck, we should do a whole Joss Whedon thing too, man. All the movies, I'm down.
Yeah.
He hasn't really made a lot of movies, though.
No.
Because we did Buffy, and like, we could do Angel, and we could talk both Avengers movies.
He wrote Toy Story.
Yeah, yeah, really. First, I think you were saying that one time, actually.
Yeah, him and Joel Cohen wrote the first
That's
Toy
wild,
Story.
Actually. It is kind of lame to kill her like that, and that's why like Bill's telling her like you can't kill her like this.
Yeah, it's no honor.
Like I shot her in the head and she's still alive. You can't just inject something into her and kill her.
Yeah,
like, that's a lame death considering she's still alive.
Yeah, well, she's not honorable because remember she poisons the sensei's fish heads.
Yeah,
that's
where
fish.
She loses her first eye though.
Yeah. He takes her fucking eye.
Actually, there are certain parts of I just don't like the third act. It's so funny because I love the third act in this movie.
Yeah.
And the third act in Kill Bill Volume 2 is so fucking boring, man.
I like it a lot. The third act might be my favorite part
in Kill Bill 2. Volume 2? Like, I think it starts out the like it's did Michael Madsen. Well, we'll talk about that one.
Yeah, okay.
We still got Death Proof, and then we'll get to Volume 2.
Yeah. No, I think Volume 2 is next. Then
is it?
Death Proof.
Yeah.
Just back to back.
Relatively close.
Yeah, because I think it's 2004. Like, it's filmed at the same time. They just split it. Like, I think it's only like 6 months apart.
Was it? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, that is pretty wild. Like, Spielberg did that with Jurassic Park and fucking Schindler's List. He's like
going
back and forth. Yeah, he's shooting both of them at the same exact time, man.
That's a fucking tone change.
Yeah.
What a master. That's crazy.
We could definitely. I don't know if I ever want to watch. I'll have to. We do a Spielberg one.
Yeah, I watched it once. That's enough for me.
Yeah,
I never.
Well,
want to
I have
it.
To take notes though, because there's the little things I don't remember. Like I'd love to watch it again, but it's just.
I'll watch it if you watch it.
That one.
Yeah, I'll watch it if you watch it, but it's a struggle.
They had the guy from fucking Billy Madison or Happy Madison. He's the guy that wants to like he's paying the guy to fuck her.
Yeah. Oh yeah, Kill Bill. Okay.
Yeah, that's the he's also Emma's boy as well.
And he goes into detail what he can and cannot do. And it's just so gross.
Oh, that's creepy as fuck. I could just see Harvey talking about this stuff. Yeah, fucking Grandma's Boy is hilarious. So I always tell people we gotta watch Grandma's Boy, man.
Yeah, Grandma's Boy is great
because it didn't get enough love. It really didn't.
No, it was straight to DVD, wasn't it?
No, I went
Pretty
to
sure.
went to the theaters,
oh,
but there was no Red Band at that time, so they couldn't show the good stuff. So it was like a PG trailer, so it just didn't look very good, man. It looked really mediocre at the trailer. So I watched it when I was working at Blockbuster, and I fucking howled.
Yeah, it's so funny.
I'm like, this movie's fucking hilarious, and it's getting absolutely. We had one copy of it when it first came out, and then there was like fucking a whole wall of Paul Blart fucking Mall Cop.
Fuck Mall Cop.
Oh god, that movie.
Kevin James just sucked anyway.
He was all right in the day, and then it's like right when he joined fucking Adam Sandler, he went to shit.
Yeah.
Because he was all right, and like King of Queens, pretty funny. I've seen some funny stand up he did, and then it just he went to hell. Ugh. It's another topic, though.
Yeah.
And she bites his lip, it's pretty gnarly.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. It's stretched. That shit stretched.
Yeah, she must have done something more to him because he's dead. She kills him after that.
Yeah.
But she can't walk, so I'm like, how did she kill him? She probably did something to him, like slit his throat or something.
Yeah.
She does remind me of Mila Jovovich, though. Like, the two of them together, there's like, because they're tall, they're skinny, and they can kick ass. So I'm like, Uma Thurman and Mila Jovovich are very similar in a lot of ways.
Mm-hmm.
So she cuts his Achilles tendon. Oh, I knew she's going to do it, too. Because I haven't seen this movie in a while. I'm like, she's going to cut his tendon. That's always gross. Because, like, if you cut that tendon in the foot, it, like, goes up into your leg. It snaps and it's pretty gnarly when it actually happens.
Yeah, I've seen quite a few movies do it. I actually watched Child's Play 3 in October and there's an Achilles cut.
They
scene.
Cut it? Yeah. Well, you're fucked. If that goes, you're fucked. Like, that's like sports industry, like injuries, stuff like that. You're done if your Achilles tendon goes.
Yeah.
But that's why it's Achilles. Achilles! That's
what
happens to him.
Yeah, and then she gets a hold of Buck. Where's Bill? Fucking slamming the door against his head. That was
pretty
crazy.
Flashback.
Yeah.
So you're Buck and you like to fuck, eh?
Yeah. Kill that fucker. That was pretty satisfying.
The sunglasses look familiar, though. I'm like, are those the sunglasses from fucking True Romance? I'm like, I don't know.
Could be.
Because what's his name? Fucking Christian Slater is rocking that Elvis look the entire, all of True Romance.
Oh, yeah.
It's a possibility because he wrote it and he had probably a huge part with True Romance.
I totally forgot about that Elvis part. Like, all those like Elvis scenes.
Elvis is even in
it. Yeah.
He's not in it.
But. Yeah, but yeah. Like his. Yeah, it's like
they don't even show him. They just show him talking.
Yeah, he's asking the king what to do.
I'm down for doing that one, man. I haven't seen that one in a while, too. That one's got a really good score.
Oh, we still have room. We can do Dust Till Dawn in that.
Yeah. Oh, there's a, yeah. Yeah, From Dust Till Dawn's a lot, too, as well. It's really good. Yeah, oh, fuck. I'm not a feet guy. I don't get it. I don't understand it. They're ugly. Feet are ugly, man.
Yeah.
I don't get it. I'll never understand that fetish.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty odd one.
It is. And it's huge. It's only getting bigger, too. You hear people talking about it all the time.
Yeah.
I was watching Hell's Kitchen yesterday, and the women were talking about how they're selling their feet pictures. And the guys were like, this is what women talk about, eh? Like, I wrote down, I'm like, I understand, like, boobs and bums and stuff like that. I understand that fetish. I just will never understand the foot fetish. I don't understand. I don't know. And Tarantino, movie, what is it? Wiggle Your Big Toe.
Yeah, Wiggle Your Big Toe.
Now we're going to O-Ren.
O-Ren.
I, like I said, I love Lucy Liu.
Yeah.
They make a funny point, Lucky Number 7, that, because she's only like 5'1", man. And like,
yeah, she's pretty small.
Totally looks like she's about 5'8". Because like, just her stature and the way she carries herself.
Yeah.
Like, camera it happens angles. A lot on Twitch, too, as well, where you think somebody's taller than they actually are.
Yeah.
Camera
angles can do that. Like Michael Keaton played Batman, but certain scenes, the camera's angled weird, make him look a lot taller. Because Michael Keaton is fucking small.
Yeah, same with Stallone, same with fucking Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise.
Yeah, fucking tiny Tom Cruise, man.
Yeah, Family Guy.
Yeah. But like, I got no fucking hatred for Tom Cruise, man. I can tell
you. I don't
you,
either.
Like, I even did a top 10 Tom Cruise movies.
I like
fucking good movies, man.
He's in a lot of movies that are my favorite, so I can't really shit on him. It's just a Scientology thing. Like, if you weren't a Scientologist, you're probably my favorite actor of all time. No.
Yeah, that's tough to say.
Not that far, but he'd be up.
No, not of all time. He's like, I'd put Jack over him any day. Jack, and even though we're talking about Daniel Day-Lewis the other day, he's way better. Like Tom Hanks, I watched Finch the other day, and holy crap, it was good, man.
Was it? Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch it then.
Oh, there was a scene in it that was sad, man. I was like, oh my God, that is fucking great. Like, they gave the robot fucking like actual character. It was good.
Yeah, I actually watched three movies by Jim Cummings. Have you heard of him?
Sounds familiar, actually.
Yeah, he's like an indie writer, director, actor. He did Thunder Road, Wolf of Snow Hollow, and Beta Test, which just came out. Check out those if you have a spare time. Yeah. Really good.
So like we're talking about the anime thing. This is all like this is the first time we've talked about exposition through anime.
Yeah.
They do all of her Oren's exposition of like what happened to her to turn her into who she is. It's actually pretty wild because her dad could fight. Her dad's a fucking brawler.
Yeah.
He gets stabbed in the back by the one dude.
Yeah. And the blood through the bed too, right? Doesn't her dad's blood drip through the...
No, that's the mom's blood.
Oh, that's
blood.
The mom.
Yeah, because the one guy stabs her right to the thing and she does the whimper thing. And like the whimper comes out of her mouth and she puts it back in there so they can't hear her. And she kills the head guy. Luckily, he's a pedophile.
Yeah.
She kills the head guy of the Yakuza, and then she, like, basically takes over.
Yeah, then the part out at the table there is like, I'm not taking shit from a half Chinese American half breed, and then she runs up.
Amazing,
man. Yeah. Cuts his head off. Like,
she gets on the table so fast.
Yeah.
Like, boom. Like, she was just waiting for it. She's like, oh, yo, if he brings it up, I'm going to chop his head off.
Yeah.
And he brought it up. And like, she probably told all those guys, too. Like, don't fucking talk about my heritage.
Yeah.
In a negative way. Like, if you do, like, you're not going to like it.
Yeah. Does any motherfuckers have anything to say? Now's the fucking time. Yeah, that's so crazy.
Awesome. There's not one person I really hated in this movie.
No, I don't think so. You know who I like the least is probably Uma Thurman, even though she's amazing too.
Yeah, yeah.
She's a star. Like,
well, it's a star role because you're in the most scenes sometimes.
Yeah.
You've seen enough and you liked it. You want to see more of the side characters. So it happens a lot. In different Tarantino. Stuff.
Definitely too with Tarantino.
Like sitcoms too are big with that. Like Seinfeld. So many people hate Jerry Seinfeld.
I did too. I'm one of those people.
It's the side characters that really make that show.
Yeah. Yeah, Kramer and...
How I Met Your Mother.
Yeah.
Exact same thing.
Yeah, that I definitely agree on that. I didn't care for the fucking main guy.
Yeah, he's awful.
I Met Your Mother.
Like,
Robin
Patrick Harris and Friends. The exact same way too. But Friends really went
up. Yeah, they're all made.
Ross.
Yeah.
Ross was big, though, at the very beginning of that show.
Yeah, because the Rachel thing made him, like, you wanted him to, the geek to get the hot girl kind of thing.
She's fucking hot in that show, man.
Yeah. Season 2, Rachel? Jesus.
Oh, so, season all of Rachel. I'll never hate on Jennifer Aniston. Ever, man. She's even hot in that new morning show. And I'm like, holy crap.
Fucking need to watch that. She's
55 years old and she's still a smoke show, man.
Yeah.
Same with Angelina, though, as well. Fucking Brad Pitt.
Yeah, I know.
He had them both in their prime.
Yeah. He's prime the only Jennifer one that could do that.
Prime Angelina Jolie.
It's Brad Pitt, though.
Yeah, but still. Like, you've got to be the luckiest man. I think he knows it, too.
Yeah, I know. He's dying.
I think I am the luckiest man of all time.
Yeah. I go to bed and wake up with a smile on my fucking face. Yes.
Yeah, because I'm Brad Pitt. I wake up.
Who gives a fuck? I fuck these chicks.
I do love Japanese, though. I love the language of Japanese. I love the, I love the sternness because the going guy, because Uma Thurman, she needs a sword. So she goes to Buddy's place there, to the bar, and she's basically talking about how she needs something to, because she chops one guy's sword, the one guy that opens the door. I love that. It's very subtle. And she calls out Oren, chops the girl's arm off.
the first Sophie, guy that fights her. Yeah.
Because he didn't know what he was getting into. He was all cocky. And fucking, she chops the sword in half right away because I guess the steel is hardcore.
Yeah. They don't go into huge detail about her steel, like her sword, but you know, it's like. Because Oren's like, no, there's no way that's that guy's sword.
Yeah, that's the very end. She's like, no fucking way.
Yeah.
She shows the logo, though. She's like, and then at the very end, when she.
Yeah.
Chops the top of her head off.
That's the last thing she says, yeah.
Yeah, this really, there really is a, because you have to, really do have to have something to chop that part of your head off.
Yeah.
Like in such a swift and the end fight scene is amazing.
Yeah, the whole setting they're in and everything.
But like, there's just a scene with Sonny Chiba and Uma Thurman, just all of it, because it's about like 10, 15 minutes of them just talking. And it's just so good, and the music's so good. I'm like, because there's like certain like
the Asian atmosphere
wind instruments that are amazing.
Yeah, it's the RZA.
Yeah, it's just that sound. They do a lot of like in Star Trek and stuff. Like, I gotta figure out what these instruments are, because they give me chills every time I hear them. Like, I love that instrument so fucking much.
I think it's the flute.
It's like an Asian flute of some sort, like a Japanese flute of something. It's a wind instrument of something, though.
Yeah.
It's awesome sounding. And the one thing in Hero, that I think Tarantino produced that, too. Where they're fighting, where fucking Donnie Yen and Jet Li are fighting. But they're fighting in their heads, and they're playing that, like, fucking... one guy is playing the music. Have you seen Hero? You've seen Hero,
right? Oh, yeah.
That seems amazing. And they're not fighting. They're fighting in their heads. And it's pretty cool.
It's pretty neat.
Yeah, that movie's awesome too.
I want to rewatch Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon too.
That movie's fucking incredible, man.
Yeah, I should rewatch it then.
That one's got a really good score too. Like, I can actually listen to that score just sitting around.
I think I was 10 when I watched it. Like, it's been that long. Really? And it was subtitled too. I couldn't follow it as a kid.
Yeah, well, you have to train your eye. You really do.
If you don't train your eye
for subtitles, you're not going to get into it.
Yeah, I'm definitely trained now.
Yeah,
that's all I did. Once you do it,
you're not even noticing you're reading anymore.
Yeah, like during COVID, I binge watch a lot of fucking Japanese movies. I like know certain words now when I hear them.
Like, I know arigato and konnichiwa. Konnichiwa. I love when he's talking to her too. He's like, "You're saying it right too. You're fucking got a good ear. You're actually saying it right." He's fighting with one guy too. I just love how he's like, "Yo, you motherfucker!" He grabs his hand. Like I said, the whole scene was good, and like it was just them shooting the shit with each other. That's Tarantino. She's pretty hot though. I got a thing for Uma Thurman, straight up.
Yeah,
pretty hot.
Yeah, and I think for Tarantino, I think Kill Bill and Once Upon a Time in Hollywood are his favorite movies he's done.
Really?
I think he's most passionate with this one and Hollywood. Like those are his babies.
You could tell you probably spent a lot of time in Asia. So he probably grew up watching them. Because a True Romance, that was probably him.
Yeah, it's a kung fu. He loves kung fu.
Kung
movies.
Fu movies, old kung fu movies, which I do too.
Yeah.
I love new kung fu movies. Like if there's fighting and kicking and swords, man, I'm fucking in. I love the end of this movie.
Yeah. And then the fucking Raid came around and just brought that shit to a new level.
That's a gun fu. Well, gun fu has been around for a while.
Yeah, but I guess it is gun fu.
Like John Woo's been doing gun fu for fucking like 30 years. Yeah. Like then he did like Face Off and stuff like that as well.
Yeah.
But he did a lot of stuff in China. I think John Woo's Chinese.
Yeah. I think The Raid might be my favorite action movie of all time. It could be.
Well, they're
The Raid?
The first one. And I still haven't seen this part, great, this part of this, all the second one.
Oh man, two's great too. I drove to Newmarket to watch it and with no one in the theater. It's the only place that was playing close to me. It's Newmarket. It's like a half hour drive just to watch that.
So now we're at the
yeah. The 1-2-3s, isn't that what they're called?
Is that the band?
Something like that. Apparently Tarantino was in Japan, I'm pretty sure. And he heard it in like a music store and he asked who they were. And then he asked them to do that scene. So it was like a total fluke that song and that band's in there.
Yeah. This whole scene's great. Like, cause it's leading up to the third act.
Oh, this is Showdown at House of Blues.
Oh, fuck, it's so good. Like I was saying, there's a lot of tracking shots in the scene. Yeah. There's a lot of,
it doesn't stop either.
No, it's craziness, man.
She kills a swarm, then she looks at her, and then she's like, you hear the bikes pull up, and she's like,
that's a pretty cool scene, actually.
Yeah, she closes her eyes, like,
fuck. Well, she fought Gogo first. I think her name was Gogo,
I think so, yeah, which was fucking cool.
Yeah, I like that weapon,
that's great. Yeah,
and it's like Shang-Chi, the fucking, she uses a weapon like that too in that movie. Shang-Chi was amazing, by the way.
Yeah,
like, yeah, the new Marvel, it was great.
Man. That was fucking great. That might be my favorite Marvel movie.
I'm still like, nothing will ever top fucking Infinity War and Endgame. Nothing will. Well, nothing will touch those unless something else comes out later, like a fucking Avengers versus X-Men, and then do the X-Men really, really good.
I think I like Shang-Chi better than Endgame, but not Infinity War. I like Infinity War the best, I think.
Well, Endgame's a tough watch because
Infinity War is like Empire Strikes Back.
and Infinity War is good through the entire thing.
That's like, Empire Strikes Back.
Boom. You're off to the races, Infinity War.
Yeah, that's fucking great. And the opening, fucking, it's like watching Empire Strikes Back.
It is like watching Empire Strikes Back.
It's like, this is our fucking, this is our Dark Knight, Empire Strikes Back.
Yeah, the middle, yeah. Well, I guess it's 3 and 4, but they're like
the
same movie, basically.
I guess. It's kind of split, I guess.
Because everybody forgets about Age of Ultron. And they did Age of Ultron better in What If than they did in the actual movie.
Yeah, the What If episode was good. What If
great,
you won?
And both of them was great.
The Zombies one was cool, too.
Which one?
The Zombies.
Yeah, I enjoyed that show, like, wholeheartedly. Yeah. I enjoyed the Killmonger episode. I thought it was fantastic. Yeah.
But
that's another thing, though. We could go on and on about Marvel.
Oh, yeah, we got
the Eternals is out now.
Yeah.
And I'm interested about the Eternals just because it was at Nomadland. Chloe Zhao, I think her name is.
Well, I'm glad they stepped up their animated game, Marvel, because DC's way better in the animated category. Oh,
it's not even close.
Not even close at all.
I can't even think of, like, there's no, like,
Spider-Man TV movies. Show.
That's good. Fucking... Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah, that was fucking great.
Compete with any of those Batman movies, man. Those animated Batman movies.
I don't know. I think Into the Spider-Verse might be my second favorite Spider-Man movie of all time. It might be number two. Because Spider-Man 2 is my number one. But it's a toss between Spider-Man 1 and Spider-Verse. They're like,
man, I can't wait to see Deadpool and all these, man.
That's going to be weird.
He's gonna it's going to be great.
Yeah.
Oh, no, they'll have to make rated R. Yeah, or you can go, but they made Venom rated PG. I don't know. I still don't know how they did it.
Yeah, but they can blur out when he said stuff because he's in a PG movie. And it could kind of be a joke on itself.
Yeah, that's true.
Like if he's like, oh, beep. And then like, I don't know. He's like, oh yeah, I'm in a PG movie. Like they can make fourth wall jokes and stuff.
I just love when she chops her arm off. It's just so out of nowhere.
Yeah, Sophie.
Yeah, she's like half French and half.
Yeah, that starts everything off. It's like, oh fuck.
Yeah,
shit's going down. The chick's in her heels. The older lady, she's like screaming through the puddle of blood. It's kind of funny.
Yeah, it reminded me of Kung Fu Hustle a bit too. Kung Fu Hustle was with the Axe Gang, and there's a lot of Axe Gang in this one too as well.
That was a great movie. I forgot about Kung Fu Hustle.
Yeah, Kung Fu Hustle was amazing, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's worth a watch, and a lot of people definitely haven't seen that one. Because Kung Fu Hustle is like a Looney Tunes meets like martial arts movie.
Yeah, it's really bizarre.
Yeah, it's great.
Here's the other one, really Kung Pao Enter the Fist. That's another one.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Kung Pao? Yeah, Kung Pao. Yeah, that one's just innovative, though.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's actually 88 people. And I'm pretty sure, like, I was counting them, like, I don't think Crazy 88, I think they're just called the Crazy 88.
Yeah. They definitely just called it.
Yeah, because I think there was probably 30 tops. It's just surrounded by them when they all pull in there. And like it looks like a lot, but then they do like it because Quentin Tarantino does a lot of the cool like shots in the rafters. Because they do a cool shot at the very beginning with when she's fighting, they do shots in the rafters, and then in the restaurant, he uses a lot of those shots in the rafters again as well.
Yeah,
like a bird's eye view of the fight. And it's just a cool shot.
You know what we forgot to mention about Jackie Brown? The fucking Toronto Raptors bag.
Toronto Raptors bag?
That's the bag fucking Samuel Jackson holds the whole time.
Well, when Michael Keaton was saying it was purple?
Yeah.
No, it's not purple. It's a white bag. Yeah. I didn't realize. I couldn't see it. My eyes aren't ready, so.
Like, we're from Canada, so yeah. It was a pretty cool deal. He's like, I got my Raptors bag.
So I should have caught that one. The Raptors, they're literally playing in an hour. Back to back. Yeah, this is another one where the soundtrack is completely iconic. Another one, like every one of his movies. Even like fucking Hateful Eight, he won the best score for that.
That was Sergio Leone, wasn't it? Or what's his name?
No, it's like Enrico something.
Yeah.
Sergio Leone was the actual director.
Director, yeah, that's right.
The guy did the Enrico something.
Well, yeah, he did the score for Good, Bad, and the Ugly.
Good, Bad, that iconic.
The same guy did Hateful Eight.
Fucking love that. Like, I still haven't seen that movie fully through, actually. One day I should watch that fully through.
Yeah, it's fucking pretty great. I watched a lot as a kid. My nana used to watch just Clint Eastwood movies. Seen all the old ones.
I saw Deadpool and fucking
Hang 'em High,
Dirty Harry. I saw them all as a kid, but I don't remember them at all.
No, I don't either.
Like at all. Of course, you remember the scene when I don't think it's Dirty Harry, but it's. I think it might be Deadpool. I can't remember which one when he says, you know, I may have shot five or shot six.
Yeah.
Do you feel lucky? Well, do you?
Yeah.
That's only Clint Eastwood could pull that line off. There's not very many actors that could make that cool.
Yeah.
Because he's awesome. Clint Eastwood in a Tarantino movie would have been wild.
Yeah. I find they probably argue a lot on set. Because he's a director too.
Yeah.
And a writer.
It's like a doctor. Or like working on another doctor.
Yeah.
Then we got this whole... There's at least three Wilhelms in this movie too. At least three Wilhelm screams. When they're fighting, I'm like, hey, there's a Wilhelm.
Oh, that!
Now to hear the Wilhelm.
Yeah.
It's a great sound. It's a great scream, and it's been used, I think, since the 50s. Because what's his name, George Lucas put it in Star Wars.
Yeah.
It's in like every Star Wars movie, I think.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
If you put it in Star Wars, you can put it in any fucking movie.
Yeah.
If you get the scream of it from a galaxy far away.
I don't know where that Wilhelm came from. It was just some.
It's from a movie. Yeah.
I think in the 50s. I'm pretty sure it was the 50s.
No, I don't think... It, Oh, yeah, never mind. I heard something that it wasn't the actor. They tried to like dub it over and he did it on a mic and they edited it in there.
Oh, yeah, I can see them doing that.
Yeah, I think it was something like that.
Yeah, which calls out Oren. Oren, it's just great. Now you know shit's about to go down.
Yeah. And I love all the black and white fucking blue light fucking fight scenes. Oh, man, that's so great. It just wouldn't stop. I remember watching. I was like, I don't remember it being this fucking long. Her just slicing through everybody. It's like a half hour.
Just so one part where it's like the scene from Leon the Professional with Gary Oldman.
With the pills?
Everyone!
Yeah.
That's what it reminded me of. Fucking yeah. Oren would just like seriously send everyone. Seriously, go get everybody. Like, go, yeah. Gary, we should do that one too. That movie's fucking
great. Yeah, that's great, man. I'd seen that late too. I seen it just like maybe 6 years ago.
What, Leon the Professional?
Yeah, I saw it pretty late.
The movie's it's weird though.
It's a weird one. Gary Oldman's fucking, when he takes the pills, he's like,
I can't. Chameleon. I really can't rant rave enough about Gary Oldman, man.
Yeah, me neither. He's like he is appreciated, but he's still underrated. That's what I feel like.
Even though like he's been nominated about like three or four times, only won once.
What was it? Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy?
No, he won it for The Darkest Hour when he played Wilson.
Oh,
he actually won that. Won it for
Did
it.
He win?
But I didn't think well, he becomes that. Winston Churchill in that movie.
Man. Yeah.
He doesn't have a British accent, and it's craziness. He's American, I believe. I'm pretty sure he's American.
No, I think he's British.
Is he British? I don't even
know. Well, he was in Harry Potter 3.
But I have to look it up and find out where he's from. I think he's American. Because like he does that in True Romance. You absolutely can't even tell
what it's I know. Thought it was White Boy Day.
Nobody knows it's him.
No, like, no,
that's Gary Oldman. No fucking way. What, really? Yeah, that's Gary Oldman.
You want an egg roll? I thought it was White Boy Day.
That movie's so good. I'm looking forward to talking.
What's his name? Drexel. That's his name.
Drexel. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was like the last one that Christian fucking Slater was really good in too, as well.
Yeah, because I fucking hate him. It's the only movie I'll watch him in.
So fucking, they do a lot of really good sound design in this movie. They use because she does like a backflip and she sounds like the Bionic Woman.
Yeah,
I think that's why they did that, is to pay an homage to that.
Yeah.
Oh my God. A lot of like cool fucking blood splatters.
Yeah, a lot of cool ones. Angles, like filters, the like camera filters, did a lot of stuff in that.
Lying down screaming.
Yeah. Yeah, at the end there where she's done, they're like, oh, they're all just moaning. Fucking bodies everywhere.
They kind of do the same thing in Django. After Django took out like fucking 50 guys as well.
Yeah.
They're just sitting there screaming. Because in real life, it's true. Like a lot of these guys are not going to die right away. They're going to die.
Yeah.
They're not going to be dead, right? They're going to be writhing in pain the whole time.
And a lot of movies like don't show you the aftermath like that. Like the wounded people, like in John Wick, like he never looks back and see all the people he shot in the head.
Well, there's a lot going on in John Wick. There's a lot of headshots. So those guys are dead. Those guys are dead. The guys that I think they counted them.
Fuck, isn't
like, it increases by like 100 every movie as well?
Isn't John Wick 4 and Matrix 4 coming out like the same month?
Same time, yeah.
That's why you
see the trailer for Matrix Revolutions or the Matrix, whatever it is.
It has to be a week apart, though, right?
The guy, he's got a beard and long hair in the new Matrix movie. Because he can't cut his hair, and he can't shave his beard.
Yeah, I know. That pissed me off. I was like, he can't do it.
Like, unless they use fake beard and long hair for John Wick.
That means he chose John Wick over the Matrix.
What's more iconic? As a franchise?
I might
like John Wick better.
Yeah, I do like John Wick as a franchise.
As a franchise.
Well, like the Matrix like moved down on my list after I saw it, because 2 and 3 ruined the whole mythology.
Yeah, the first one's so good though.
Yeah, no, the first one's
better than John Wick, but John Wick 2 and John Wick 3 are better than Matrix 2 and Matrix 3.
Oh, fuck it. By far.
Because they're only getting better.
Of all the movies, the Matrix still the best. Well, even if Matrix, you out of all franchise, like
probably my top 10 of all time.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to do that one again at some time as well.
Yeah, but if there wasn't 2 and 3, wouldn't it be higher on your list if there was just the Matrix?
Oh, I kind of look at the Matrix as a standalone. Like the other two are kind
of. I do too.
Like I don't really didn't really need it. They only did it just because of studio
money.
Here's a fucking $1 billion and do whatever you want to do. You made enough money. And they're like, okay, we're gonna put the whole third act's gonna be about the architect.
This
notorious scene, it's so boring, it's so convoluted.
Yeah. And he says so many things, but he didn't really say anything. Like they answered other questions.
Revolutions isn't terrible. I had a really good time one time. I was at home and we had a really good stereo system and a really good television. And I put on The Matrix Revolutions and like it was good. I had a good time watching it, I'm not gonna lie.
I'd probably choose Reloaded over it, but
I like the stuff fucking Zion and fucking the mechs and stuff like that. And
that was cool.
Fucking cool, man.
Yeah. It's just like
any of the Neo stuff, which is fucking weird.
And the sweaty rave shit. I didn't really thought that was.
That's sweet. Reloaded.
It's all three, you know? Or no?
Oh, that's like the very, very beginning of Reloaded. I didn't like the scene, and I didn't like any of the Neo stuff, actually. They fucking really bombed Neo. Yeah,
they CGI looked dated than the first movie.
Yeah, like, this like one here's done. No pool. Fucking CGI, really. This, like, there's no.
Tarantino has no CGI.
There's no fucking annoying edits, too, as well.
Yeah,
that's the one when I related her to Mila Jovovich. That's one thing that her husband does is edit the crap out of her fight scenes. Yeah. Like I can't watch something that's too heavily edited.
Yeah, it hurts. Ah!
I'm imitating shaky cam right now.
Yeah,
I don't like shaky cam and a lot of edits. And that can make me feel sick, man.
Yeah, they do it a lot in concert footage too. When you watch bands.
Yeah, I don't like shaky cam. I don't like shaky cam, and I don't like fucking cut. Like for a throw, and they cut it about six times. Like, really? Seriously?
Yeah.
To harken back to John Wick, they don't do that. It's a lot of fucking static shots of him fighting. They very, very rarely do they cut three times during a fight scene.
Yeah.
And that's awesome. Give me that all fucking day. Yeah. What's it? So, I think it was Born Identity. Started the shaky cam fighting.
Those pretty good movies.
They're good, but then people they noticed it. Like, yeah, it was kind of cool. And they started doing it, and it becomes like The Matrix.
Yeah, the time it came out, it was cool.
Because how many things fucking copied The Matrix after that came out?
Oh, fucking millions. Revolutionized fucking special effects.
Yeah, with bullet time and stuff like that.
It's like Jurassic Park started at the beginning of the 90s and then they ended with The Matrix.
Yeah.
Whole evolution.
Yeah, Terminator 2.
Oh, yeah, Terminator 2, yeah.
But Jurassic Park was a big one because that was like, if you watch the movies
that made that looks real, man. I watched it the other day. I was like, that was fucking really well done T Rex, man. That looks fucking real.
That's it. Spielberg knew. He knew right away. Like, this is the future of fucking a film. Like, sorry, buddy.
The puppeteer guys.
Yeah, the guy who does all stop motion. He's like, hey, you're dead. Basically, you're extinct.
Yeah, the movies
I made. Bad for him. But that'll be back. Well, like, we still see stop motion. And like, Wes Anderson still uses, like, stop motion.
Yeah.
And, Bets Animated Movies do use that as well.
Can't watch Wes Anderson.
I like the Life Aquatic. I like that movie.
I know. I like the Grand Budapest Hotel. That one.
I didn't hate that one. I didn't hate Rushmore. I didn't hate that one.
What was the one with the fucking Boy Scout one with Edward Norton?
I don't even remember. Moonrise Kingdom.
Moonrise Kingdom, yeah. Bruce Willis.
I don't even really remember that movie.
Fuck, I don't want to, man. His movies give me a headache. I don't know what it is.
Fantastic.
Again, it's stylistic.
Which is kind of meh.
Yeah.
And Silly Rabbit, Tricks Are for Kids. I had it down. Like, I really did like that.
What a good segue.
Yeah. That's what, because she knows, basically. You didn't think it was going to be this easy, did you? He's like, for a minute there, yeah, I kind of did. She delivers that line pretty good, too, actually. That's when they fucking storm in there. The whole scene is great. Then they fight because she takes her shoes off too. And I'm like, wouldn't her feet be cold?
No, because I don't think is it actually winter there or is that just a special room? It's just like a design.
Yeah, that's
room.
What I'm saying. Because like, it was it weird has to because be. All the other, when they're outside, there was no snow before.
Yeah, I think I just noticed that. I think it's like a studio room, like for her, because she's like a fucking kingpin, right? Yeah. So she would have tons of money for it.
Yeah.
That's what I think that is, because that always weirded me out too. And the weird like satisfaction of close-ups by Tarantino, like the water dripping in the
yeah
in the wood thing, it's just like something so cool about it.
Yeah, they really, there's like a huge contrast actually between the crazy 88 fight and the fight with Oren, because it's they slow it right down.
Yeah,
and it's still good, but it's like that either you're trying to like, because you got the stance there and you're trying to figure out how to go in and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And a lot of times, fucking Uma Thurman's like creeping on her, like she's stalking her, like a predator. I'm like, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, maybe she takes her shoes off, it's like tick, 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 and the music starts going. It's so
good. I'm not going to have a hard time finding music for this.
I had a big smile on my face that whole
time. This is probably my favorite score or soundtrack. I don't know.
Yeah, that's a hard one, man.
Reservoir Dogs has got a really good soundtrack, too.
Pulp Fiction does, too.
Yeah, they're all.
So is Jackie Brown.
Yeah, well, they're all good, yeah. And then, like, you get to the other ones. And, you know, I don't even remember anything from Inglourious Basterds, actually. That one's coming up, too. That's like the three more movies we're at Inglourious Basterds.
That's like.
You haven't seen that movie like, fully through. I haven't seen Inglourious Basterds.
Fucking great, man. That's my favorite Tarantino, my favorite movie opening ever.
Oh, Brad Pitt's so good in that movie, too.
Yeah.
Oh, when he's talking the Italian, it's so fucking funny, man.
I think Christoph Waltz steals that fucking movie. Oh, every time he pops up.
He does it in Django too.
Yeah. I don't think he's stealing. Yeah, maybe.
Oh, man. You knew he was going to be nominated, but you also knew that there was actually that movie was fantastic from the acting standpoint.
Yeah. Oh.
I think we're talking about before, all of them could have been nominated. Every single one of them in that movie in Django.
Yeah. Samuel L. Jackson, did they snub him for DiCaprio? DiCaprio was the one that got nominated.
DiCaprio's just a little bit more, I think.
I think Samuel Jackson.
I do think
better.
He's a little bit better.
I think DiCaprio Samuel was better.
Part in that movie, man.
Yeah, but Samuel played a black slave who really loved his owner.
Movie,
he's fucking, and he has like a fucking old man like shake to him. He's like, I thought he was better because I could tell Leo was Leo. Samuel Jackson that movie sometimes.
He's never played a bad guy like that before either, though.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah, it's awesome. He's such a good bad guy, and you like fucking hate DiCaprio in that movie.
Yeah,
but that's good though. That's like Joaquin Phoenix and fucking Gladiator type of good.
Yeah,
it took me a while to realize that when I was a kid, like younger. I'm like, I hated it, the actor, but then I realized that
you like it.
It was their job.
Yeah, you love to hate it.
They're meant to.
Yeah,
piss you off. That's if the more they piss you off, the better job they're doing.
Yeah, it's like when Kurt Angle comes out and they chant that you suck, but you fucking love it.
Like, you know what I mean? One of those guys want to hear.
Yeah,
they don't want to hear silence. They want to hear the boos and the you suck. That better than the pop. The pop probably feels really good though. I still say Stone Cold got the best pop.
Stone Cold's the best. Period.
I think he always had the best pop when he like all of a sudden.
Oh, that glass shatter.
The glass shatter.
Yeah.
But If You Smell with Rock is Cooking was a good one.
Yeah.
If You Smell. The Attitude Era was awesome, man.
Yeah, that was a good time to go. I was like a kid too. Like I was like seven, so
I was
age.
A little older, but I was fucking really into it. Like 16, 17, we're all hanging around watching Raw. Every Monday, we watch Raw.
Yeah, every Monday we did too,
On Thursday or whatever. But because Stone Cold wasn't on it, and like Stone Cold was huge.
Yeah,
he's still selling merchandise to this day.
Yeah, I'd still buy a Stone Cold shirt if I saw
I would
one.
Too. I want to get one actually. Because there was just a documentary made. I love those wrestling documentaries.
Yeah, man. Wrestling documentaries are so good.
Yeah, because you don't get to hear about all the stuff that's going on in the locker room and stuff.
Did you
like
see
that.
The Iron Sheik one?
No, there's still a couple. I saw the Piper one. The Piper one was good.
It's on Prime, the Iron Sheik one. You'll fucking love that one. That was one of the best ones.
Iron Sheik, that generation was a little before I really started watching wrestling. The wrestling was like about 89, 90. I really started watching it.
Yeah, Hogan was Hogan.
Yeah, and Ultimate Warrior and fucking when they first brought in The Undertaker, which was a fucking great documentary.
The Last Ride.
The Last Ride? Oh man, it was amazing. I'm like, wow. Yeah. Because a lot of people argue he's the GOAT. It's funny how we got to wrestling.
I don't know how we did.
I think because we were talking about pops and just different stuff like that. But we're talking about villains, actually.
Yeah, that's right.
Because you do love to hate a lot of
Kurt villains. Angle, that's how I brought him up. I mentioned Kurt
fucking,
Angle.
Is he that Hans Landis, I think his name is?
Yeah.
Fucking Christoph Waltz in Inglourious Bastards. You really do kind of like to hate him because he's kind of an ass.
Oh, man. He's great. That opening scene is just unbelievably acted.
He is a good actor, though.
Oh, my God.
That was the other guy first too. Thing I've ever seen him in, too, really.
That was his first movie in Hollywood.
Was it?
Yeah, because Tarantino... He's
Austrian, I believe. I'm pretty sure he's Austrian.
Yeah, because Tarantino couldn't find the right guy for the part, so he was at, like, a Broadway show in Germany, and he pointed him. He was in a play, and he's like, yeah, I want to come to the States and do a movie. He's like, what the fuck, really?
Yeah.
Well, all of a sudden, Tarantino.
Yes, and then he wins a fucking Oscar because of it.
Let me do it again. Another Oscar.
The guy with the exceptional beard.
Yeah, the guy with the exceptional beard.
I think DiCaprio is just a little bit better than Sam Jackson in that movie. Because, like, he's just a fucking... just a spoiled brat, basically, in that movie. Yeah.
And again, the least best character is Django.
Yeah.
He had a pick.
He was nominated, always, too, though.
Yeah, he was a star. It's always, like... I felt the same with when we did Buffy the Vampire Slayer. It's like, Sarah Michelle Gellar is probably, like, my least favorite character. Buffy.
Yeah.
I think Xander, Willow, Giles, Spike, Angel were all better characters. It's just like a cliche protagonist. Like, you have to have that.
It really is hard to really get behind a protagonist fully. Yeah. Like, a lot of the times you go, like, Vegeta Goku. You wouldn't believe how many people are Vegeta fans. Or Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah. He's like a vigilante. He's like Batman.
Yeah.
He's like on his own side.
Because, like, Bret Hart was fucking pissed about how the fans were turning on him. Because, like, that's when Stone Cold was really coming into the zone there.
Yeah.
Bret Hart was like, oh, what the fuck? Everybody's starting to cheer for this guy now? What's going on here? It's just funny how that works.
So did we talk about how Uma Thurman chopped Oren's head off? Did we get to that yet?
Yeah, well, we talked about that in, like, a little earlier. But
we did.
It was that this really is a Hattori Hanzo sword.
Yeah.
Because it has to be sharp to, like, to cut the tip of your fucking skull off like that.
Because
I forgot. I thought, I'm like, wait a sec, how's she talking? I'm like, oh, I just chopped off the tip of her head.
Yeah.
Like, right at her scalp, basically.
Like, half her brain.
Yeah. Oh, she's dead, though, of course. Like, I think once the oxygen hits her brain like that, you're pretty much fucked. I don't even know what it would feel like.
Yeah, and then it's a really cool shot when she's in that the biker helmet and she's opening the trunk and talk to that girl. That's really cool.
They do a lot of cool shots with the biker stuff, actually. It's really, really quick shots, but I guess he's looking for her, looking for Oren, and she's on the bike and she looks over and it's the French-Japanese chick is beside her. And I think she follows her to Oren.
Yeah.
That's when we get there. This movie is incredible, and honestly, I would give it a 9.6 out of 10.
Is that your rating?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I could have rated 9.3.
It's very entertaining, man.
It is.
Like, I don't even find myself a little bored. Like, I very, very rarely even jumped on my phone. I was like, and I fucking love this movie.
I just want to say, like I know we rated a lot of stuff nines, but we're reviewing, like, a lot of our favorite movies.
Yeah, we haven't done any bad movies.
Yeah, before. like mediocre. I think the lowest we gave was Buffy. We gave, like, a 7. I think that was the lowest.
Well, rating. I think I gave Return of the Living Dead, like, a 7.5 or something like that.
I thought you gave it, like, an 8.5.
I don't think it was really that. Like I would say, that is above average, though. Yeah, it's still 75%.
That's like a 9.5 for me. Yeah. I love that fucking movie.
I'm not really much for the camp as much as you are. You're fucking all on board for camp.
Yeah. Well,
that too, camp and stuff like that.
Yeah, but when it's well done. Like, I won't watch, I don't like that whole genre, kind of, but those stick out. And Sam Raimi.
Like, I'm not even that much of a fan of Dead Alive. That movie's fucking pure camp, man.
I like that movie. It's entertaining to watch, like, not as a whole, but the gore is just insane.
Yeah.
And Dead Alive.
That movie's, like, it's notoriously the goriest movie of all time.
Yeah, when her, like, her ear drops in the soup, and then she eats the fucking ear in the soup.
Like, I'm telling you, I haven't seen that movie in years.
That's gross.
Maybe man. Next year or sometime we'll do, what is that, Peter Jackson? We do full Peter Jackson too as well.
Oh, fuck, man. I don't want to sit through The Hobbit and Lord of the Rings. I really don't want to.
I do Lord of the Rings once every couple of years, man. I fucking love those movies.
Lord of the Rings, I would. I don't
we could kind of skip over The Hobbit, but I'd love to talk about like Frighteners and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. Underrated.
Fucking really. I saw that movie in theaters too. I really, really like that movie. It's maybe Michael J. Fox kind of came out as like fucking Parkinson's. He's in bad shape.
So you gave this a 9.6?
9.6 out of 10. Yeah. Like nice. I said, this one, every time I watch it, I get just a little bit more entertained.
Yeah.
Because like if I did my top 10, and I think this one, he was like fucking second, third, last. And now it's now it's probably... okay, I almost would put Reservoir Dogs number one again. The Reservoir, the Django, then this
one. Yeah, well, wait till we watch them all. You'll figure it out.
Because I had Django, Reservoir Dogs, Pulp Fiction, Hollywood. Yeah, my whole top 10 is going to change.
Yeah, we'll tally at the end of the month. We'll have our fucking ratings.
I'll do a full out fucking video about that.
Yeah.
I'm down for that. That'd be cool.
Yeah, me too.
We could talk about it for a while, especially after just having them fresh and you're like going through all your notes about everything. And
yeah.
Okay, yeah, all right, yeah, cool. All right, let's fucking do this.
So I guess volume 2 is next.
Is it volume 2? Okay, we'll do volume 2.
We might as well, even if it's not next, like we might as well fucking.
Yeah, we might as well. We could have done it in one video, honestly, but it's that's like a 3-hour movie. So
yeah,
we would have been talking for another probably an hour and a half. Or hour at least.
Yeah.
I think we've probably been going on an hour right now.
Yeah.
Give or take. Maybe even more, actually.
Yeah, I don't know when we actually started. A little bit more.
But yeah, this was fun. I enjoyed it. Like you said, you said 9.3.
Funny how like,
I said 9.6 and we differ with our opinions on different things.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to do this. Because like if someone, unless they said Death Proof, but if someone said any of these movies their favorite Tarantino movie, I wouldn't argue with them. I'd be like, yeah, I can see if Kill Bill's your favorite or Jackie Brown. Like, it, you disagree, but it still makes sense in a way. You're like, you can't.
If they can back it up, they can't. If they just say like it was good, why? I don't know. I just like it. I hate that. Say, I'm like, come on, give me something. Why you like it a little bit better than that one? I just like it. Yeah. I like the it's a good movie.
Yeah, I liked a lot of
talk to you anymore.
Yeah, this Kill Bill, the origin thing was really fucking cool. Everything about this movie I liked. It's just, I don't know. I can't tell you why. I
feel a little bit better next time I watch it too.
Yeah. And like, I can't explain why I can't give it a 10. Maybe because of the genre. Like, I'm not, I rather the sit and talking Tarantino than the action packed Tarantino. No, that's why I think I gave it 9.3.
Give me the action.
Yeah.
I was in for this one.
It's like the Avengers and stuff, like CGI is like, I'd rather just have them sit and talk than watch the CGI fucking action scenes, man.
Give me the end game when fucking Cap says, Avengers, assemble. Yeah. Oh,
Avengers,
assemble. I still can't even get over it.
I watch this big green screen with no atmosphere. I hate it. Can't stand those movies.
Which one?
I like the Marvel because when I was a kid, like I loved the superheroes. It's great seeing them, but it's all green screen. I just Sin City's the only one I could. I don't like CG.
The first Sin City's good. The second one not so much.
Oh, the second one was brutal.
Yeah, I don't even remember.
Disappointment, man. What a disappointment.
I saw a picture of Josh Brolin and Eva Green in the Sin City 2, and I'm like, oh yeah, they were in that movie. like I remember Eva Green, but because she got that iconic poster. For the second one, that was the one thing that really sticks out in my memory about Sin City of Dame to Kill For is Eva Green.
Yeah,
but the first one, like, you do Robert Rodriguez one too as well. We could almost do that because Tarantino had a part in. Didn't Tarantino direct
Desperado
in Sin City?
No, he was a special guest director. I forget what story. I don't know how that worked. I want to look into that. Because I remember hearing it says special guest director, whatever that means. Like he
directed a sequence in Four Rooms too, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think one of the stories in Four Rooms. He likes doing the anthology stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, might as well sign off. This was a fun one. I fucking enjoyed this. Gonna add it and get it out for you guys.
Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Until next time.
And oh, then wait. Hopefully we'll have you on Spotify, and then hopefully you guys will listen, assholes.
Yeah. Yeah, I will. I'm getting on Spotify soon.
Yeah, we're coming in.
Volume 2 came out April 16th, so it's literally like October, Kill Bill Volume 1 came out.
Really?
The following April, Kill Bill Volume 2, yeah.
So he had a lot going on. Well, I think he probably filmed them both at the same time, I'd imagine.
Yeah. And he filmed this whole thing in Beijing, China.
In China? Volume 2. Really?
Volume 2.
Seriously, yeah. Eh?
I'm just reading it
now. Or Volume 2? Or because he goes to Tokyo in this one.
I know. Maybe
this one must be filmed in Japan.
They're both probably filmed there.
And the other one, because the other one is China. That's where she goes. She trains with the guy there to become Beatrix Kiddo. To become the bride. Yeah, he stands on the sword. That's a cool scene. Yeah, he jumps up and he's got like the 1 foot on the sword.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I haven't seen it in a while. That's why it'll be fun to talk about.
Yeah,
it,
this actually. One's really fun. I like to talk about this.
I like what's happening. I found myself a little bored with the third act. This one here, never bored.
Yeah.
But like, there's so much. The movie's called Kill Bill.
Yeah, you never know. You got to go in not having that in your mind, though, when you watch it tomorrow.
That it isn't, yeah.
Yeah, just have a free mind.
Yeah.
It's the best way to do it.
Yeah, but like I said, I worked a midnight shift before I watched it, and I didn't go to sleep. And we're like, yeah, like if you smoke weed before a movie, you're already burnt out halfway through and in a theater.
Yeah, I know. I see.
So I don't like doing it anymore. I haven't been to a theater ever, man. I like being able to pause it and like have a coffee or something and fucking relax for a minute. I don't like sitting in a theater for like 2 hours straight. It tires me out, and I'm always fucking exhausted by the time I leave.
I know what you mean. You're kind of sluggish and tired.
I don't like theaters anymore. I used to love them, man, but now I'm just like, yeah, I'd rather.
Yeah, the older I got, I'd rather be at home. Especially with all the streaming shit. You can just fucking.
And most of the time nowadays, that's because that's the way it's going. People still like the big screen. Like the IMAX, but it's dwindling and it costs too much money. Go see a fucking theater in IMAX or a fucking movie in IMAX with your girlfriend and you're paying. You're looking at $100, man.
Yeah, man. Those seats are like 30-something bucks now.
And then you want to go for dinner. Dinner in a movie. Dear God, you're looking at fucking $200.
Yeah, it sucks because in high school, you take her out on a Tuesday, get a slice of pizza, each for like $5.
Yeah.
Get a movie for $4. You're under $20 date.
Yeah. Now it's fucking insane. $200 date, easy. If you spring for everything.
Yeah, there's no way.
All right, guys, we're gonna sign off. I hope you guys have a good day. Like and subscribe, motherfuckers.
Yeah, peace out.
Peace.